There you go. You're wearing it.
I'm wearing it, yep.
Tell me the news.
We found 42.
All right.
Do you want to see what it is?
Yep, all right.
Are you ready? -80538 all cubed, +80451 cubed, +12631 cubed.
All right, there we go. And why is this significant? Why is 42 a bit of a milestone in this field of endeavor?
So this started a computer search from way back in 1954. They were looking for the numbers up to 100 to see which of them could be represented as a sum of 3 cubes. And we've now just answered that 65 years later.
So this is it. This was the last one?
This was the last one, yep.
Okay.
And it takes 17-digit numbers to get there. That's why, of course, they had no hope of ever finding it in 1954.
I saw you recently when you'd found 33, mm-hmm. and you used a big computer not far from here at the University of Bristol.
That's right.
Was this one found by computer, the same computer?
No, this is actually much bigger, so we had to go another order of magnitude beyond what I did for 33 to find this. So I actually think the most interesting aspects this time around were sociological rather than mathematical. So after the 33 news, I got lots of offers of help. Had to turn most of them down, actually. The first thing I did was go straight to Drew Sutherland at MIT. He's a world expert at this sort of thing. We teamed up and, you know, modified the code to make it run at a much bigger scale. The other thing was we got a big offer of help from Charity Engine. So they harness the power of millions of volunteer PCs. Okay, and that gave us a computing platform that's, you know, massively larger than anything I could get as an academic. And that's how we found it.
So some of the people watching this video, if they're involved with Charity Engine, may have been involved with the discovery.
That's right, yeah.
Okay. How did you find out? How did you find out that there'd been the breakthrough? How did the news get to you?
The Charity Engine guys emailed us with the solution.
Right. Did the email say, great news, this is amazing, or was it really a perfunctory email? Or
just said, we have a solution. Here it is.
Can I see the email?
Sure, it'll take me a minute to dig up.
All right. How did that feel when you saw that? Were you just like, yeah? Or were you like, yeah, and jumped up and down in your underpants? Or
I didn't do a jump for joy this time, but yeah, it was pretty satisfying to solve something, you know, that's been out there for decades. We're not finished, of course. Okay, so the next number after 42, with no known representations, is 114. That doesn't have quite the same ring to it. But there's actually another number that we care about more, and that's 3. K equals 3. So the reason this gets ignored is there's a couple of small solutions. Actually, you want to have a go? All
right. For 3?
Yeah, so 3.
Okay. Well, 1 cubed plus 1, or do they have to be unique?
No.
Oh, so 1 cubed plus 1 cubed plus 1 cubed?
Yeah, very good. Yeah. Okay, and if you play around for a little longer, there's another one you can find. And it's 4 cubed plus 4 cubed plus negative 5 cubed. So 4 cubed is 64, another 64 is 128. Take away 125 is 3. A mathematician called Mordell asked in 1953 if these are the only two solutions. We still don't know. That's kind of what kicked this whole thing off. That's why in 54 they started looking. They were hoping to find a solution for 3. We're going to throw everything we have at it and we'll see. But, you know, with this kind of thing, you never know. It's a once-in-a-generation kind of thing, so.
Are you going to throw any resources at 114, or is it just getting silly, constantly going up and up and up?
Yeah, so there's another 10 below 1,000, which would be the next milestone. I think I'm ready to hang up the hat after we have a go at 3, but yeah.
So you'd rather get a different solution for 3 than the first solution for 114?
That's right, yeah.
There are 10 numbers below 1,000 that you haven't got.
That's right,
yeah. Only 10?
Yep. That's right. So there were 13 when I started this. I found 33 and then 795. And we just found 42.
Well, congratulations.
Thanks.
Are you going to celebrate? You doing anything to celebrate?
It's my wife's birthday today, so yeah.
You got her a nice present. That's her present,
right.
Is it? I think she's going to want more than that. Flowers, maybe.
I think so, yeah. And so if we just look at the numbers up to 100, so let me say k less than or equal to 100.
The interesting thing is for k less than 100, we now only have 2 more numbers to worry about here. Who knows? It may well be that if you just look up to 10 to the 16, you'll find a solution.